training with my girlfriend, so Sonata's jumping in. Whatever it takes, get big or die trying.
What? Motion can fit on there, bro.
Yeah, stack to that. You know, motion can fit on there. Sonata's just had a lactgasm. First time she's ever had any time for an orgasm since her last boyfriend. Hey guys, how's everyone doing? Hopefully everyone's well. We are in Planet Fitness Bargoed. Welsh. We're in Wales, we're in Cardiff. Here for Josh's peak week. Josh, don't come in yet. We're not introducing Josh. We're here for this video. It's going to be upper training with my girlfriend. So Sanaya's jumping in. We're going to do upper. We are here basically based off the fact that Josh is currently 5 days out, which is pretty wild. So now, Josh, come in. Come in. Come to.
What's it like?
Hello, everybody.
How are you feeling?
I remember I said to you just then, I was like, I don't feel nervous. I don't feel excited. I'm just a bit meh. I'm sure when like a bit of food goes in, I get like.
Yeah, what we'll do, guys, is today in this video, I don't know how much it won't be more than twice. He's already mentioned it about 5 times today, and I've seen him for 10 minutes. So,
because I wanted to ask what my food is tomorrow.
Oh, here we go, counting up. So, Josh is currently 5 days out from
the trend working now. Now it's fucking working.
From PCA First Timers, the 24th of September. By the time this video is out, you guys and girls might know already how Josh has done. So hopefully it's a good result, both in the class and potentially into the overall, we never know. But overall, it's gonna be pretty much a case where today's video is going through almost just an upper body session. We'll get some clips of Josh towards the end, see where he's at from a video standpoint. And then tomorrow, we're gonna be filming like a day in the life. It's the first time that me and Sam have actually been like collectively together for a whole day, and it's not where like we're at a show or doing something that I can't actually just be in like my normal sort of day-to-day life mode, if that makes sense. Yeah. So we'll actually go through a bit of a day in the life. So yeah, not really too much of a plan today in the sense of like what we're doing, me and Sanaya. For me, it's pretty much like I said, an upper body session where we're gonna be taking you through an upper body session. I don't actually have an upper body day currently in my split, but I've changed a few things around based off this week, weekend to come, the fact that I'm absolutely battered after me deadlifting and I'm desperately in need of a deload. So we're taking 2 sessions and then we're gonna be having 4 days worth of rest, which to be fair is needed. Performance is in a really good spot. I'll do a current update situation throughout the video and all that sort of jazz. So yeah, other than that, like I said, we're here for Josh. So we'll see how he's looking. Excited. But for him, you're doing push today, aren't you?
Yeah, I've got push.
Yeah, so push at like 1 RAR, but in reality, just keeping things fairly similar. Like not being an idiot with loading, not taking 2 to 3 rep maxes and stuff like that. And if anything, actually effectively training. So
yeah, actually doing something.
Yeah.
Actually and getting a stimulus.
Exactly. And what we've also done is we've given him 100 grams extra carbs and we've slowly started to pull down expenditure. So the first of almost like the peak week tweaks, which to be fair will be a reel that we talk about in the sense of what we're actually doing. But we'll cover that tomorrow because Josh is coming around for an in-person check-in tomorrow morning and we'll go through there. So hopefully you enjoy. That's that. We'll catch you guys in the video. Sound. Two pulls. I'm gonna do a horizontal press and a vertical press. We're waiting for. There's not a good Smith here. It's a Matrix Smith. Shout out anyone who goes to a Pure gym that has a Matrix Smith. Like I feel for you, bro. It's awesome. I feel for you, sis. Whoever uses it, it's awful. So we're warming up on a flat bench. We're gonna do a low incline barbell. Just based on the fact that there's not actually that. Like the pressing kit here is pretty good. The shoulder pressing kit is really good. They've got a Prime shoulder press and an Atlanta shoulder press. But when it comes to a horizontal press, especially for me loading wise, I actually want to be able to like fail within like a 5 to an 8 rep range. The hammer strength, I'll have 6 plates on there, I'll have to band stuff. And in reality, I just don't really fancy doing that. So yeah, low incline barbell, guys are finished. So that's what we're going to be doing. And like I said, 2 presses, 2 pulls. We're going to do a delt tricep, like a little bit of metabolic work for the delt. So front raise, side raise, rear delt fly, and then literally just a bit of blood flow to the arms. It's how I like to program when it comes to upper body sessions. And as always, we'll take you through. So first exercise. Low incline barbell, let's see what we get. Okay, yep. 3, 2, 1, yep. Get home, eh?
Yes.
Come on. Yes, yes. Go, go, go. Ooh. Yeah, lovely. Come on then. Yeah, drive. Yes, come on. Yeah, lovely. Yeah.
Ooh, Sam. Looking all over the place. Zero stability, maximal vibes.
Haven't you done four on this before?
Not on an incline, no. Oh. I want four on that. That'd be quite good. Not four reps, four plates. So that was 160, four reps. It's quite funny, the weight feels light, but I'm just not used to it mechanically. But I do want this in, and I played around with this on my Friday push session at Evo. So I think I'm gonna have this in because I don't really get too much of like a interference. I've got a little bit of a niggle. Nothing too bad, just like my front delt tying to where my pec is. And on any medium incline press, especially that's like loaded more so in the shortened range, so most machines, it feels a bit naff, but that actually feels pretty good. Obviously, barbell heavier than the lengthened, so kind of makes sense based off my own slight niggles. But that felt really good, even though it was only four reps, just a little bit all over the place. So mechanically, like if I was to do that next week, I'd get that for like 6 to 7. With body weight going up as well, I'd get that for a fair few more reps soon. So I think I'm gonna keep this in. I think I'm gonna keep it in. The actual bench itself, I've never used the Nautilus incline press or incline bench, but it feels really good. Like the angles feel really nice. So yeah, 160 there, drop it down to three plates as a back off, which is cool. And in my head, I'm like, if I get really, really strong at an incline barbell, if I then go back to a flat bench, I'm gonna be pretty decent. I've done 200 kilos for a triple, and I quite like a five plate flat bench in my off season, depending on how long the off season is based off when I'm prepping next, but we shall see, we shall see. So yeah, decent, decent. Yeah.
Ready?
3, 2, 1.
Yep.
Yeah, on me.
Come on then. That's it. Easy, come on then. Come on, Rich. Let's go. All the way. Yes, lovely. Come on then. Yeah. Come on now. Let's go. Drive it up. Yes, yes, yes. Come on. Finish it.
Oh, yeah, so.
Come on then.
Nice. Cool. No chance. Woo. Three plates for 11. Probably maybe a 12th, but I didn't really fancy the initial change of direction, my pec, and then I'm not gonna blame Sanaya, but like if she who tried to grab it and I like buckled, it'd be a bit of a mess. So one RAR, fatigue management. There's a good thing a deload's lined up in 2 days. Hopefully, that's sarcasm. Yeah, you just weren't close and it's an awkward angle. So when you initiate the press on this, it just feels a bit awkward, but it's a real nice angle. It's like a medium sort of incline. So yeah, three plates there for 11, 160 for four. With more stability, more vibes, more experience, more body weight, this will be easily four plates. So that'll be the goal. Four plates on this, get this up to something pretty silly, close to 200, then transition back to a flat bench and press five plates. Simple. That's gonna work, it's gonna happen. What I'll do is I'll get Sam to save this, make this a reel for when I press five plates on a flat bench in like 6 months. Good. So
your veins. That was like a blood pressure PR.
Blood pressure PR and a PR. What's not to love, bro? Yeah, six plates there, shoulder press. First movement, like I said, horizontal, bit of an incline, but this is the vertical press, Atlanta shoulder press. If you make this a legit shoulder press, in my opinion, it feels pretty naff, especially with like the arc of press. I like to have this as almost like an upper chest slash high incline press. So hips a little bit further forward, almost like creating a bit more of a high incline press so I can really kind of initiate it off my upper clavicular region of the pec and likewise my anterior delt. So yeah, six plates there. Felt really light, to be fair. Like, it's annoying that you can't fit more plates on because I'd fit more plates on. JP, I saw him do 8.5, like 2. I'll get that. I'll get a bit more, I reckon. Shame I don't have the physique, because he's way stronger and way bigger than me, but it is what it is. You win some, you lose some. I lose a lot, I just fit pretty strong somehow. Good, come on, air in a go. Your bracing was so bad for that second rep. You didn't breathe. You knew that was heavy and you proper was like, you're like, no, it's just like, you could have, you that rep, last rep, you should have had. I think if you had like locked out and almost thought, fucking get your air in, get tight, because I think it got into your head, it was a bit heavy, but it was split in half. Do I do your next set, or do I do a plate? Something that I think is really undervalued, and I'll give a shout out to Cuba. I'm not going to say his surname. Cuba's surname, is it Ceiling? I've already said, I'm not going to say his surname, I've said it. I remember on a video from like 2019 and touching upon like bracing and utilizing the eccentric on the shoulder press to get a sharp breath in, and if anything, kind of push your diaphragm up and create a better pressing angle. Something that Sanaya, and I'm not rinsing her, but her bracing wasn't the best based off the fact she didn't breathe. She didn't breathe. She took an eccentric with no breath in, and as a result, a shoulder press, literally you're trying to create stability against the actual, let's say, angle of force. So force is pushing you down and you need to press up. You need to create stability through the floor, and then likewise through your torso, say torso, more so through your body, your center of mass, to create that stability, to be able to press. So if you don't breathe, congrats bro, you're not getting stability. No stability, no vibes. No vibes, no growth. We want growth, we want vibes. So make sure you utilize the time on the eccentric is to really try to get as much air in that you can, and really, if anything, anchor yourself into the floor through your feet, get tight, and then press. Right, so Josh is currently day one into his, I say carb up, it's not really a carb up, it's a linear carb load. So 100 grams extra carbs, and literally we're just discussing regarding food choices and selections of food choices, because cream of rice in a prep, in a diet, is lovely. Like, yeah, everyone likes cream of rice, but the volume of cream of rice, water, weight, in the actual sense of how you cook it, it can mess around with digestion.
Even like brands and stuff, like there'll be some brands which have like digestive enzymes added. Yeah. Some will just be like, right, what tastes really good? Throw that in there. But yeah. Then, it's the same food, but it doesn't digest well, does it?
So basically what we were discussing is actually the food choices. So we're going for easier food choices. We're going to be experimenting with a bit of cereal, sugary, easy to get in. And then we've literally been saying like pretty much crumpets, jam, rice, food that we've already got in. A carb up is not a time to be throwing in something like pasta or anything that's going to be, oh, it's a carb, can I have this instead? We're keeping food choices very similar, but extremely easy to digest and low volume, so it's not going to be causing any GI or just digestive
like,
stress.
Oh, here's food, let me just have whatever I want. You've still got to be sort of quite meticulous with the actual specifics of it.
Yeah, so 100 carb going in today, extra on top of his usual training day baseline. We'll put the baseline up on the reel. Tomorrow, we're going to assess how he is in the morning, and then we're going to go from there in regards to more food, probably another 100 carb on top of what we've already added. So it'll be 200 carb on top of his usual training day baseline, but we'll see how he looks. So yeah. A linear load is just very much a case of doing a bit less and eating a bit more, but just trying to assess the response. So let's say we go 100 carb on top of your baseline today, 100 carb tomorrow, 100 carb Thursday, 100 carb Friday. That's 400 carb that we've added on top while doing less. So your movement demands, like ideally Friday, Saturday, the second you get to Sanaya's on Friday, you are not moving. Like it is minimal movement and just sitting around. Good, really good. Pulls. No, let me interject.
No.
You can't.
Look. Let me show you the demonstration. Plate is here. Rack is here. Plate. Let's go.
Realistically, those plates were literally on the floor. I have not actually got them off the rack, they were on the floor. So I've literally, all I've done is lift the weights and then put them kind of back where they were. Anyway, we're not gonna be here again. Like, they ban me, who cares? I'll just go to a different, there's another Planet Fitness like 15 minutes, but I'll just go there and get banned from there. What? So, pressing work is done. Two sets on the Atlantis. Incline, incline, high incline. I make it, it's shoulder press. Six plates and five plates. Motion can fit on there. We're now, that sounded so cocky. The motion can fit on there, I'm sorry. But that legitimately is the reason why I did six plates. Sounded so cocky that, didn't it? Motion can fit on there, bro. Yeah, stack to that. You know, motion can fit on there. Sorry. I didn't mean that as cocky as it sounded. Moving on to pulls. Similar sort of thought process. We want a horizontal challenge and a vertical challenge. I flip them, so I start off with the vertical. So we are doing a pullover. There is a prime pullover. I've never used this bit of kit. Sanaya was asking why and what we were kind of, let's say, placing on the prime bit of kit to challenge wear. Now, the lats are stronger in the lengthened range. So basically in this lengthened position, they're stronger as we get our elbow lower down. As we get the lat short, it gets weaker. So in theory, you could say, well, it makes sense to then potentially make it lighter in that drop. So we have a drop off in that shortened range, but our lats are also fresh. So I quite like to almost, bit of bro science, but in my head I'm thinking, well, my lats are fresh and they can only get short and contracted and, like, let's say, and get into that contracted spot and flex hard against it when you're fresh. So if anything, placing a bit more of a challenge there, as long as the resistance profile doesn't look horrendous when it comes to those last few reps. So gonna give it a bit of a go with it challenging pretty much that kind of mid to shortened range. So as our elbow comes down, as we start to get it in and almost complete the rep, that's when the challenge is going to be, if anything, emphasized. And then we're gonna go for two sets. Potentially for the second set, we'll manipulate where the actual challenge is. And this is, if anything, something that you can overthink, like jump on a bit of prime kit, find what feels best for you. And if it feels good, sound, crack on. The only thing is, don't change it week to week, or don't do what some people do, which is they don't know what it is and they just go in and just do it whatever the last guy left on the machine. And they just go, oh yeah, I progressed by five reps this week, or it felt really bad, or it felt awful, because you didn't check where the setting is. So make sure to check where the setting is. So yeah, two sets here. Manipulate the resistance profile if needed, but ideally first set mid to short. I'll let you know if we change it for the second set. Brutal. Really good though. Main goal of this off-season, guys, outgrow every single pullover machine. If I can fit into the pullover machine, I'm clearly not pushing hard, up hard enough. So more food. More food.
Just more food, yeah?
Just more food.
Just more food.
As a natural athlete, you only have food to play with. I don't have many tools to play with, okay? Isn't that right, Sarah? Good. Come on. Good. And again. Good, go for one, go for one. Last set on this. Come on, elbows down. Yes. Yeah, lovely.
That was all you.
Kind of was.
Fried.
Yeah.
Like,
it's really good, isn't it?
It's a lat-gasm.
Lat-gasm. Sanaya's just had a lat-gasm. First time she's ever had anything
any
close.
Type
gasm. Any time for orgasm in fucking year. Since she knew me, you know, since her last boyfriend.
I'm just with you.
Oh. Don't know what to say. Yeah. All right, fuck it. Let's do this as the air buddy road today. Three, two, one. Yeah, yeah, hold me.
Oh. Come on then.
Lovely. Oh. Sound?
Yeah.
That was a good dead stop. Yeah, buddy, T-bar. YBTBR. Ooh. Train hard, progress at all costs.
No, but generally it looks like you're bruised all over.
Whatever it takes. Get big or die trying. What?
I don't want you to move back on
your heart. No, I can't. Can't touch upon heart attacks. Someone said on the weekend, like, yeah, after my second heart attack, you know, really been questioning if it's worth it. I was like, what?
There's only more one.
Yeah, just have one. It was actually just a warning call, you know. Just, I mean, maybe, maybe not. Nah, second one, that's when you're like, oh yeah, it's serious. I'm gonna proper shag this. This is gonna get like proper, this is gonna be awful. No, I think I'm just gonna go straight in. No, come on. I'm doing a drop set, so there's no fucking point. And again. Might as well do a rest pause. That was the slowest drop set I've ever seen. Did you forget? Did you forget?
No, I couldn't
grip
it.
Sad. Awesome. Well, guys, so no difference. Josh is still 5 days out. I mean, technically with time, he's actually a little bit less than 5 days out now, because he'll be on stage in less than 5 days, believe it or not. But yeah, just going through some posing, seeing how he looks. Like, I see Josh, I speak to him literally every day. Like, he's been checking in daily for the last like 6 weeks, probably. So we speak every day. After his sessions and all that sort of stuff, which to be fair at this point is needed. He's where he needs to be, pretty flat, like looks tired. And like you can tell in like just his breathing, like his natural inclination is not to get all his air out. It's almost to pose and be tired, because when you're 5 days out and you've only had a little bit of extra food and cardio is slowly being tapered down, you are gonna be tired. So at this point, it's really, if anything, making sure that you're actually staying on top of the things that you can control in sense of quality. And like, he looks so much better now, just going through that round of posing than he did at the start, because he's actually getting all his air out and posing correctly, which when you're tired, it's probably not gonna be the case. So yeah, exactly where he needs to be. Plan of action for this week is literally take it day by day, see how things are. More food going in tomorrow, less movement. More food going in the following day, less movement. Following day after that, probably minimal movement, even more food. Hopefully we can slightly spill over into Saturday, but if I'm honest, I think with how like conditioned he was, like I don't think you're not gonna spill. Like, it's, if we can have like half a day of drying out, quote unquote, we'll be sound. But even if we were just to run a linear load up to the show day, it's consistent and it's gonna be lesser likelihood of error, which I was actually saying to Josh in regards to a linear load, which is something that we will probably do a reel about. It's the most consistent and stable when it comes to like potential outliers. We could do a front load, which is kind of like a safe load. You could do a back load. And in my opinion, a linear load, best of both, and then kind of just monitoring the look and going from there. Unfortunately, not many people get to that point because you don't have time. You've got to be pulling off body fat. Josh realistically has been men's physique condition and probably leaner than he needs to be for a pretty long time now. And it's going to be a case of, yeah, 3-4 weeks, but he's where he needs to be. And when you get lean and get ahead early, it's good because it means that in between shows, we're not going to have to be going back to the trenches. Like, the vast majority of the fat loss is done. Like, it's a case now of refinement.
I reckon reversing out from that.
Pretty much. yeah, pretty much just doing a bit less and eating a bit more, which will be nice. So that'll be fueling training performance, which is what bodybuilding is. It's training, it's not just dieting. If it was dieting, Josh would be in the gym for fucking 60 minutes and just then doing cardio and doing steps and not eating anything. But in reality, it's bodybuilding. So the main goal now is to drop off stress, drop off fatigue. If anything as well, keep your head screwed on in a positive way. Josh is very easy, and this is probably a negative part of him, is very easy to be a bit negative and almost get in his own head and overthink and overanalyze, which is normal. There's some people who don't do that because they're unadherent and they're fucking slacking, and they're just, Josh is almost too on it at times that it results in him overanalyzing, when in reality at this point the vast majority of the work's done, the conditions where it needs to be, and you just need to literally, believe it or not, listen to me and you'll be absolutely sound. So yeah, all is good. Session for Josh is done. Josh is going to shoot home. We've got a little bit of rest of the session because I've entered coach mode, need to switch off coach mode now, go back into athlete mode for a little bit of metabolic work, and then cardio, Sam's going to train, and then we're going to get to the Airbnb. So yeah, all good. Sit here on tonight as well, which will be good, so you can just sit down and watch some football. So
we should win as well, so that should be pretty, like, nil-nil, 80th, kill myself. Don't get that in the video.
That's Josh being negative, I'll kill myself. Sam, all good. It's a tri-set, isn't it? So once I'm in. So, metabolic work done for the delts. Same tricep is actually on the last video, which isn't out yet by the time I'm videoing, but it'll be out soon. Front raise, with a dumbbell chest supported. We then have a dumbbell lateral, and then we also have a rear delt fly. Literally three sets of each, so 9 total sets, no rest time. So, high reps, 15 to 20. Sometimes towards the end, I'll introduce like a drop set or rest balls or something like that to modulate the intensity, drive it up. But the main goal is just blood flow, metabolic stress. So. Yeah, do your metabolic work. One of the main drivers of hypertrophy is metabolic stress and mechanical tension. But we've already got the mechanical tension at the start of the session, now metabolic work, to get as much blood flow to the delts as possible. So we're here, my watch has died. It's a little bit later. I'm currently in the process of making my post-workout meal. If you want to know what it is, await the next video and I discuss what my post-workout and my whole day of eating 800 carb on a training day, which is sound, to be fair. It's not that high in comparison to what I have had it before, but I will most likely have to have it. So yeah, video wrapped up. Good end of the session, good session in general. It was upper, so a little bit of an unorthodox sort of session, so we had a bit of fun, which I felt like you should have when you're training in different sort of places, like just having a bit of fun, training hard, and just turning up and getting stuff done. We've got lower tomorrow. Sam is going to be jumping in for lower, but it's going to be a full day in life. That's going to be quite exciting. And it's just going to be a case where tomorrow's final session prior to a 4-day deload, which, just judging off my aura ring absolutely hates me since me deadlifting 300 kilos and then 310 kilos. But hey ho, it is what it is. So a little bit of fatigue management and all that jazz, 2023, can't do a video about saying fatigue management. But no, the session was good. Everything was like literally spot on as it should be. And yeah, that's the outro of the video. Hopefully you enjoyed. Stay tuned for the day in the life. We've landed in the Airbnb, gonna watch a bit of football, chill out, and yeah, that's that. Catch you guys next video. See you later.